sometimes people get overwhelmed. What are all these constructors I have to create? What are all these spaces? Different things like that. And they want to we wanted to also extend UVM to add some specific features of being able to inject faults. So in terms of simplifying UVM adoption, for example, an example that is the test class. The UVM test class, you have to know a little bit about the phases, you have to build objections, things like that. But we build that into the code class, so you don't have to worry about that. Makes it just a little faster to bring up your initial environment. Then some of the extended features that have been added and go to UVM, the ability to inject faults into different locations in your design, so you can mimic what happens if you have random faults occurring inside your automotive system. Whenever you start injecting faults, then you need to have something that allows you to predict what the log file is, so that you can still do checking, because if you're adding faults in, then suddenly you're getting a different result out of your system. You need a way to accommodate that. And there's a library of checkers also, and different user UVM verification components for registers, low power, etc. So I'm going to mainly focus in on the test layer, signal access layer, and log predictor. There's a wider variety of what I'd be able to squeeze into this presentation. Talking about directed error injection, for looking at something like the LIN protocol, you have a serial bus that is communicating through the automotive system, and you need to have the ability to inject errors. So some of those errors might be more at the transaction level. Individual, you might be wanting to accommodate an error inside the UVM transaction that you're creating. And some of those might be built into the different UVM components, things like the drivers. And so some of the typical errors you could get in a serial protocol like LIN, delimiters, checksums, different type of errors that could happen, we need to be able to inject those errors and show how the system will react in those different cases. And so the universal verification component that you're using should have knobs to help control all this type of error generation. So where do we put all this type of control information? In UVM, basically, you have two classes. I'm sure this is all very easy for all of you. Let's go through it really quickly. We have the components that are hierarchical, and transactions or sequences which are not aware of the hierarchy that they're working inside. And then the users write the sequences and virtual sequences for their tests. And they need to be able to access information from the sequence to be able to inject those errors. But that information sometimes is stored over inside the UVM component. There's multiple ways of storing those different knobs. And in the go to UVM, we'll show you one solid way to do this. GoToUVM stores the knobs inside the driver agent class, and the UVM sequence now needs to reach over into that and tweak those knobs. So it's not a direct jump from going from a sequence all the way over to a component. So the sequence is running, it doesn't have direct access to where it is running in the environment. It needs to be able to find the component that it's working on. And so there are different ways to for a sequence to access its location through its sequencer. The UVM root class does have some API methods to help you do this. So GoToUVM has a class called component access. So basically, you can call this method from inside of a sequence, and it can go in and use some of the UVM features to go and access the component that needs to actually tweak those knobs. So for example, it'll have a method called getComp here that you can access, and it goes off and calls the find method inside UVM. So you pass the name of the component that it's looking for, and then it will go off and find it for you. It has some built-in error checking, and it also hides some of the dollar cast issues. For people who are newer to system Verilog, dollar cast always troubles them. It's always like, do I dollar cast the left side, the right side? This helps hide some of that issues with new users. Here's an example of using this inside of a sequence. So this sequence is needs to access the LIN driver, and so I need to get the sequence basically needs to go over to get a handle to the driver so it can start accessing some of these variables. And so the way GoToUVM provides this capability is you call the static method here, get component, and you pass in the hierarchical path inside your UVM environment to the location of that driver. And also because this is a specialized class, you're passing the type of the driver. As a result, it's returning the correct type. And so you don't have to do a dollar cast. Just some people, once again, I find it's, whenever I teach system Verilog, it's a dollar cast that seems to trip up people the most. They always forget the rule of how you use that. Once you have that handle D0, then you can start saying, hey, I want to inject these different types of errors. But it's always a challenge to try and get that handle when you're very deep inside of a sequence. And then once you have all that set up, you can kick off your sequence however you want, UVM do or start item or whatever technique you want to use. And of course, I always get ahead of myself in terms of the animation. The driver, this is our sequence that we're specializing based on this type of transaction. This is the GoToUVM method that our class that we're using. And then here's the hierarchical path and where the driver is actually stored. And then the different knobs that we're accessing inside the driver to inject those errors. So you definitely need to be able to inject those sort of errors. The one issue though is that the sequences that you're creating sometimes don't know where they're going to be running inside the hierarchy. And so you can create these sequences inside UVM and then have different sort of knobs to control those. And so the sequence needs to have these knobs, once again, to access these controls inside the system. And so GoToUVM also provides capabilities to access a component from anywhere inside the system. And debug with built-in debug messages, once again, because we find if users are trying to build up a UVM environment, it can be challenging to, if you have an error, make a coding mistake, you don't want it just to die with a null handle or something like that. So in terms of here's an entire powertrain control module that's accessing all the different parts of our automotive system, and it can be, it's constantly reading inputs in from different parts of the system, and it's sending different outputs to control the environment. It has many different fault scenarios it needs to work with. And so we need to mimic what's going to happen if we have faults in any parts of our system. And there's a wide variety of interfaces that you can be working with, from the slower level serial interfaces like LIN up to more parallel type interfaces that run at much higher speed, but obviously cost more. So as you're building up an environment with this system on chip that you're working with, it's going to have to communicate to many different components around it. And so you need to build up a flexible environment that works on all of these. And so the GoToUVM provides some capabilities to do that. And build up virtual sequences to help control how do I access one sequence that can control both LIN interfaces and CAN interfaces. So the virtual interfaces are controlling each of those interfaces. There also can be injecting errors and orchestrating different sort of parallel operations, sequential operations, doing handshake between them so that you can see what happens if things happen sequentially, for example. And virtual sequences do tend to be fairly well understood, but we're trying to now add in random faults, which can be a layer of complexity. So if you're sending through regular traffic through a virtual sequence, we want to be able to randomly inject a fault inside during that sequence. So you've got a virtual sequence which is sending out a known bit of transaction. Now you want to inject inject a random error in the middle of that sequence. And you want to be able to inject these faults anywhere inside the system. Now, if you just had a couple of points that you wanted to be able to inject an error, the standard solution to that is with a system Verilog interface. And so I have 10 places where I know I could have faults. I'll write a system Verilog interface to do that. However, if you really want to make this more realistic, if you want to make it be able to inject errors anywhere inside your system, you need a stronger approach than just the system Verilog interface. You can't possibly enumerate all the different signals in advance. Also, because there's such a wide variety of different places to inject errors, you it's very unlikely you'll use any one of those during a simulation. So you don't want to spend the effort to build up a huge system error log interface of all these different signals. So with GoToUVM provides us a way, as a set of methods to be able to, for example, force a signal in somewhere inside of the design, deposit a value inside of it on a signal, or release a signal inside the design. So now you can reach out and start applying these transactions, injecting faults randomly inside the system, because now you're not limited by a predefined set of signals inside of a system error log interface. And so this is built on the simulator's API, so basically using PLI functions or whatever the XMR functions or the every simulator has a different way of spotting stuff, being able to force and release signals across the from a system error log and just reaching out across the hierarchy with the name. And so but it works across the VHDL boundary, so this could work both in Verilog and in VHDL, being able to send out those names, of being able to specify just a random signal name, and then what values and other types of attributes that you want to communicate when you're doing these random fault injections. And so this is approach has been created to help help for safety verification, so that you can basically model what happens, will the system safely react when you start injecting faults. And so the application they created inside GoToUVM is called SFV. And so it generates, for example, it'll randomly generate a file with these random different signals and values that you're going to inject over time. For example, it might say for signal one, I want to inject the following values at these times, and then at these times, what are the time units, or are these signals inside VHDL? There's various different attributes you can put in this file. So you can manually create this, or you can have it generated for you. And so this is basically the source file of the errors that are going to be injected. And once again, I got ahead of myself on the animation, but basically I'm going to signal two, I'm going to inject the following values at the different times. Signal three, well, I want to do more debug on this signal. And then the Tickle app that GoToUVM provides, basically SFV, basically translates those input files into a set of tasks that are calling these force and release commands. So it's saying force my signal to certain values at certain times. And both signals at higher levels or levels down inside the hierarchy. And so this is the more of a low level classic system Verilog test, or you could have a UVM sequence here that's doing this. And so this SFV can also generate a UVM sequence that's doing the same sort of actions. And this is all, those tasks that you see on the left side are then being called by the code, the sequence on the right hand side. So once you're injecting errors inside your system, you're getting new behavior, so you have to try and predict what the output, how that's going to modify the output. And so I won't get into too much on the idea of mock systems, but basically mock is a software technique of how you can test systems that aren't completely, haven't been completely implemented yet, or how can you inject errors and test how your system reacts before this system has even been completely built. And so how can you predict these errors to make sure that you're really testing all the parts of your system? So while UVM has a register predictor, GoToUVM has something which is called a log predictor to help try and anticipate what happens when you inject these errors into the system. And it's built, once again, on the idea of mock frameworks. There's a number of these different tools that are out there. And so trying to predict what sort of errors will occur when you do these type of errors. And so they give you, start off with a log predictor type base class that you can then extend, but it has a method you can use inside here to predict what type of errors are you injecting, how is that going to affect the system, what is the severity of the outputs, and also control how long you think this is going to be disturbing the system. Sorry, I got ahead of myself there. So it's definitely challenging to try and verify all the safety different aspects of an automotive system, and different technologies are needed, simulation tools, formal tools. And so GoToUVM is based on UVM because that's really the methodology that's most in use by systems today, by projects today. And so GoToUVM provides some additional capabilities to make it easier to build your test bench, inject errors, and also have some basic predictions of how the results will, the results from your simulations will change. All right.